And in case anyone just hopped in, I'm Maeve. We're gonna start in child's pose. So you can have your knees narrow or you can have your knees wide. Take your arms overhead or back by your heels. Release your forehead down. Use this first moment to arrive on your mat, to arrive in your breath. To check in with how you feel, what's happening in your body, what's happening in your mood, all this good stuff. Yes, Susan, I see your message. 100% my plan. Stay in your breath. Stay in your breath. We're just gonna rock our weight side to side in child's pose. Rise onto your hands and your knees. And then lift the heart, the head, the tail up. Breathe your inhale. And then with your exhale, round your back. Inhale. And exhale. Just keep moving with your breath here. It doesn't have to be with me. It's with yourself. One more round. Walk your hands back to your knees. Bring your hands to your hips. Push your feet down. The toenails can be down or you can tuck your toes. It's totally up to you. Whatever makes you feel more stable. Don't worry, we're not gonna go crazy right out of the gate. Contract the belly. Lengthen the heart to the sky and then just open up. And start to just take the shoulders back. So just the shoulders back. And then by way of the shoulders coming back, the shoulder blades press the heart up and you get a little bit of a back bend from the upper back. But you're not going crazy far back. Just this opening here. And then come back forward. Forearms come down onto the ground. Walk the knees back or the hands forward. And then drop the heart toward the floor. Take the hips toward the sky. Your forehead can rest down. Your chin can rest down. Carefully rise up, tuck your toes, forearm plank. If you need to, keep your knees down. If you're feeling good, straighten out those legs. Heels press back hard, stretches forward. Gaze a little forward. Fingertips down so much that maybe the elbows and the forearms start to get light. Last breath in. And then release it down slowly. Bring your hands next to your ribcage. Tuck your toes. Power up your legs. Roll the shoulders open. Hug the elbows in. And then imagine pulling your belly, your hip points, your ribcage off the floor. Just imagine it first. Take a big inhale. And then exhale, do it. Lift up chaturanga. Inhale up to plank. Down dog, exhale. Bend one knee, drop to the opposite heel. And then switch. And then both heels press back, thighs press back, fingertips pressing down, knuckles pressing down. Really feel the base of the index finger, the base of the thumb pressing down, energy coming up those arms. Wrap your biceps in and back. Yeah. Biceps out and slightly apart. Your right leg back and down. With time to your left toes, open up the hip. If it feels good, lift the hips up so higher. And then right knee, right side. Inhale back, square through the hips. Exhale left. Inhale back. And then exhale, place your foot between your hands. Back knee drops down, you kneel down, and then rise up into Anjaneyasana. Feel like this right hip gets a little heavier, so sometimes this hip wants to kind of jack up because this foot just works. You can drop it down, feel like the thigh is getting heavy and the hips up. Gonna keep the back toes tucked. And then just lift the knee like an inch off the floor, just about an inch, very small. Pull your feet toward each other. So pull the front foot back, pull the back foot forward. Keep the back knee up, bring your hands down. Shift back, keep the back knee up. If you can, keep it up. Good. Now push off the back foot. Turn the back heel in. Right hand is going to stay down. Wrap the right hip under the body. Roll open. Triangle. Press into your big toes. Notice this left arm is falling back behind you. Take it straight up out of that left shoulder.
He wasn't born of love, a mother's only son, no father that he knew.
With an inhale, right. Turn your left heel in. Take the arms up to the sky. Work the arms straight, sinking down. Got it. So I'm just going to flip back so I can face you. Yes. Beautiful. Really nice. And you don't have to just hit it and be there. Feel free to kind of move around a little bit here. Play your edge a little. And then find where you feel challenged but safe. Close your eyes. Breathe. Yes. Stay there. Stay there. Last big inhale. Exhale, come around, hands top of the mat, step back to plank. Inhale, shift forward to the toes, halfway down, chaturanga. Upward facing dog. Downward facing dog. Exhale. Left leg back, lift really high into the right toes. Open the hips, stretch that left leg up and back. And then left knee, left tricep. Inhale, stretch back. Hips come to neutral. Exhale, cross over to the right. Breathe. Inhale back. And exhale, place your foot forward. Right knee comes down. Keep the back toes tucked. Rise up. Yes, yes, yes. So just like on the other side, see if you can drop this left thigh bone down into the hip socket. Level the waist. Yeah. Lift the front hip points. And then just hover this right knee off the floor. Pull the feet toward each other. So back foot pulls toward the front foot pulls toward the back. Powerful arms. Soft, steady, even breath. Notice your responses, your reactions to poses, to my requests. One more inhale. Release your hands, but keep the back knee lifted, just hovering. Straighten the front leg, shift back. It doesn't have to be all the way straight, it can be partially straight. There's lots of things in between. Really nice. Push from the back foot, turn the heel in. Root down, roll open, Trikonasana, triangle. Top ribs soften, bottom ribs lengthen. Watch this top arm. We like to let it kind of fall back because it makes it feel like we're deeper in the pose. You're not actually deeper in the pose, you're tricking yourself. Go straight up and then roll the chest open. If you want that sense of opening, actually open. And more than taking the hand back, you're actually pushing the hand forward, like you're pushing the hand forward to roll open more. I wish I could ask you if that makes sense, but I'm going to go with it for at least 3 weeks. I do miss asking if that makes sense and getting a response. Rise up in hand. Turn your back heel in. Arms up, sink down. This time, let's just find as much stillness as you can. Soften or close the eyes. Every single chaturanga is optional. You can modify it, you can skip it. Make your way to downward facing dog. Inhale, hide your toes. Bend your knees, look forward, stay with me, don't go anywhere. Malasana, bring your feet out wide. And then sink down. Good. I may not have caught you in time, but that's okay. We're meeting here now. And then same thing like we did in Goddess. If you want to move around a little bit here, just kind of find where your edge is, your center. Every pose, it's about finding your center. Every single pose. It's really what this process is about, is finding your center, your authentic self, your center, your true you. And then loving that person unconditionally. And then reach the arms up. And then press up to stand. And draw your hands into your heart, bring your feet together. Just take a pause on that idea of unconditional love. What does that mean to you? And if you have a child or family member or a cat or a dog that you love unconditionally, think about what that means. It means that you don't always agree with everything they do. Like if my cat pees on the floor, I'm going to strangle her, but I love her. So there I am cleaning it up and giving her love, even after she's done that. So can we love ourselves the same way when we make choices? Maybe not peeing on the floor, even though my baby did that today. Can we make this decision to love ourselves even if we don't love all of our choices? And then can we change our choices so that we change our behavior to line up with who we believe ourselves to be, who we feel we are at our center? Action and intention coming together. Inhale, rising up. Exhale, backward. Halfway, inhale. Chaturanga, exhale. Inhale, rising up. Downward facing dog, exhale. Right away, lift your heels, bend your knees, look forward, feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale. And then fold, exhale. Rise, inhale. Hands into your heart, exhale. Inhale, rise. Exhale, bow forward. Inhale, halfway. Chaturanga. Exhale. Rise, inhale. Downward facing dog, exhale. Inhale to your toes, bend your knees, look forward. Feet to hands. Halfway, inhale. Fold, exhale. Rise up, inhale. And hands into your heart, exhale. Inhale, rise. Exhale, bow. Halfway, inhale. Chaturanga, exhale. Rise, inhale. Downward facing dog, exhale. Heels up. Inhale, exhale, bend the knees, feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale. Hold, exhale. Rise up, inhale. Hands to heart, exhale. We go again. Inhale, rise. Exhale, bow. Halfway, inhale. Let your hands chaturanga. Inhale, heart to sky. Downward facing dog, exhale. Lift the heels, bend your knees, stretch back on no breath, feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale. Fold, exhale. Inhale, rise to stand. Draw your hands into your heart, exhale. Inhale, rising up. Exhale, bowing forward. Halfway, inhale. Chaturanga, exhale. Rise, inhale. Downward facing dog, exhale. Right leg back, inhale. Open the hip, right knee, right tricep. Gauge, extendable it up. Inhale, up and back. Exhale, cross. Baby, extend the leg out. Inhale, up and back. Exhale, place your foot. Crescent pose. Inhale. Hands come down. Exhale. Keep the back knee lifted. Bend the back knee. Shift the hips back. Straighten the front leg. Push forward. Triangle. Opening up. Inhale, rising up. Goddess pose, arms up, exhale, sink down. This time come forward, Skandasana. Good, come around, left hand down. Spin over to the left side, the pinky side of your left foot, yeah, and then Vashisthasana. opening up.
Waste not.
Good. If you're happy here in Vashisdasana, stay. If you want, put your right foot on the floor behind the left leg. And then start to open up into wild. Inhale, come around. Stay with me. Stay with me. Exhale, knees to the ground. Inhale. Ustrasana. Nice knees. Stay for the exhale. Now rise up. Chaturanga. Exhale. Upward facing dog. Downward facing dog. Left leg back, inhale, open the hip, left knee, left tricep, maybe straighten that leg out. Inhale, up and back. And then cross over right, maybe straighten that leg. Bring it up and back. And then place your foot between your hands. Crescent pose, rising up. Hands come down. Keep the back knee bent, straighten the front leg, shift back. Yes. Come forward, back heel roots. Triangle. Beautiful. Rise up to stand. Arms up. Got it, sinking down. And then Skandasana. Take a few breaths here.
Until you are heaven over. But staying out all night won't make your troubles go away.
So, as an observer in this practice, noticing your body, noticing how you're seeing, noticing your thoughts back to yourself, to me, mostly yourself. You can think mean things about me all you want, that's fine. Well, not really, it's not good energy for you. I don't mind, I can take it. But how do you think about yourself? And if any of you have succeeded in beating yourself up into being a better person, let me know about it. But I'm pretty sure it hasn't worked that way. So let's try something new and just love on ourselves like crazy. Okay.
Staying out all night will make your troubles go away.
Good. Bring it around. Step it back. Knees down. Rise up, Ustrasana, maybe a little deeper to your
core.
Rise back up, Chaturanga, exhale. Up dog, inhale. And downward facing dog, exhale.
To make your troubles go away.
Come hide your toes, inhale. Bend your knees, look forward, bring your feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale. Fold, exhale. Utkatasana, chair. Now rise up, pick up your left leg. And then push open half moon. If you want, you can keep this left leg bent and find the foot. You want to go through classical and then find the foot, fantastic, all good, good, you pick. Thank you. you have it. Come around onto the back toes. And then we'll lift the left leg up, standing split. So this doesn't have to be pretty. I want you to just forget about form and just let this happen if it wants to happen. If it wants to happen. Bend the left leg, the lifted leg, and then find your foot with your right hand. And then just take it away. Goddess, sit down. Skandhasana. pretty round. Vashisthasana. Or wild thing. Come back around. Pause, knees down. Ustrasana. I think I was so excited to do this camel last time that I skipped what came before. Inhale, rise up. Chaturanga. Exhale. Rise, inhale. Downward facing dog, exhale. Left leg back, inhale, open the hip. Knee to tricep, maybe extend leg, maybe float it up. Inhale, up and back. And then cross over. Option extend, option lift. Inhale, back. Exhale, place your foot. Crescent, inhale. Exhale, hands come down. Bend the back knee, straighten the front leg. Come forward, the back heel. Triangle, round up. Rise up. Heels in, toes open, goddess sinking down. And come right around top of the mat. Skandasana, so good. Bring the right hand down, roll to the pinky side of the right foot. So we're going to hold this one because I skipped it once. Vashisthasana or wild thing. And then bring it around to plank. Knees down. Ustrasana, camel. And then chaturanga. Exhale. Rise up dog. Downward facing dog. Exhale. Posture three. Bend your knees, exhale. Feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale. Fold, exhale. Chair, inhale. Pick up your left knee, rise up. Back move. Side angle. With or without the wrap. Triangle. Good. Maybe keep the wrap. Maybe keep the wrap. Turn toward the floor. Come onto the back toes. Come onto the back toes. Start to slide the shoulder inside of the knee even more. Mm-hmm. Good. And if you didn't have the wrap before, this is actually an easier wrap, taking the shoulder inside. Right hand comes behind, left hand comes behind. So you might surprise yourself here. If you can't wrap in side angle, you might be able to here. And then just listen, left hand comes back down to the ground. See if you can keep your right hand here. Slide that back foot in, take your time. And then lift the back leg, see if you can find your foot with your hand. Oh my goodness, and then take open here. Chair, inhale. What did you think about yourself, about the pose, about me? Be an observer, be an observer. Right leg rises up. And then half. Into side angle. Into triangle. Rebend the front leg. Start to slide this left shoulder inside of the knee. If you don't have the wrap and you want to try it now, go for it. Onto the right toes. Shoulder. feet out wider if you're in a really narrow stance. With confidence, right hand down to the floor. Start to slide this right foot in closer. Push down into the right hand, pick up the right leg. See if you can find your foot with your hand, and then start to kick it up. I didn't give you any form as far as like where you need to be, so just I'm like, where are you right now? Where are you right now? Be there. Maybe you won't make the cover of Yoga Journal, that's okay. So good. I love it. I love it. I love it. Release out. Come back into chair pose. And forward fold. Exhale.
Halfway inhale.
Vinyasa or downward facing dog. Right leg back. Open up the hip. We got another round here. Right knee, right tricep, float it up if you want. Up and back. Cross over left, float it up if you want. Inhale, up and back. Place your foot. Crescent, rise. Exhale, hands down. Back knee stays bent. Straighten the front leg. Shift forward, root the back heel. Roll open, triangle. Rise up. Goddess. Top of the mat, Skandasana. Left hand comes down. All the way open into Vashisasana or into Wild Thing.
Come on, this train.
Inhale, come around. Knees down to the ground, exhale. Rise up, inhale. Find your camel. Rise up, inhale. Chaturanga, exhale. Inhale, open. Downward facing dog.
Happy lately.
Think of left leg back, open the hip.
And
left knee, left tricep.
It could be.
Consider lifting off.
It's going to come.
Inhale,
I've
up and back.
Smiling lately.
Cross
Being
over.
Back, the world is one.
Maybe lifting
and
off.
I believe it could be. Someday it's
up
going
and back.
To come.
Inhale.
Someday it's going
Place
to come.
Place your foot, exhale.
Take me home again.
Rise, crescent. Mm-hmm. Hands down.
Come on.
Back knee stays bent. Front leg straight.
Someday it's going to come.
Shift forward. Trying. That back heel. Yeah. Rising up. Goddess, kick down. Stand up. Right hand down. Roll all the way up to that right pinky side of foot. Vashisasana or Wild Things. Come back around. Knees down. Rise up, inhale.
On the edge of darkness.
Maybe you don't use your hands.
Exhale. Strained.
Take it back.
Be strained. Take this country. Come take me
inhale,
home.
Inhale, rise.
I've been
Chaturanga. Exhale.
Thinking about the world as well.
Inhale.
And I believe it could
Child's
be.
Pose.
Someday it's going
exhale.
To come.
Pause here.
Someday it's going to come. Come take me home again. Come on, be straight.
Come forward.
Someday
forearms down.
Come
tuck
on,
your toes. You're in forearm plank again.
Take me home again. Someday it's going to come. Someday it's going to come. Someday. Someday. Someday it's going to come.
Dolphin or Child's Pose.
I can't He's a straight sound in life.
Drop your feet back.
Straight.
Knees down. Forearms forward.
Straight.
Drop the heart down.
Someday it's going to come. Come take me home again. Come on, this train. Someday it's going to come. Come on, this train.
Barefoot lift up. Forearm chest skip. Breathe.
Come take me home. Come take me home. Come take me home again. Someday it's going
walk in dolphin.
Come take me home again.
Right leg lift.
Come on. Straight away.
Bring it down. Left leg lift.
Come on, this way. Someday it's going to come. Take me home again.
Bring it down. Forearm plank.
Come on, this way.
Spread the shoulder blades. And then release the hips slowly. Release the feet so the toenails are down. Pull the heart through. Sphinx. Yeah. Good. Take your left arm. Same shape. Just bring it out to the side. Roll to your left side. Look to the right. This right leg can come behind the left leg on the floor. Right hand can give you support here. Come back to center. Tuck your toes.
Arm plank. Hey, where are you going? In the army, I feel about the arms before. I got a twitch in my pivot putting out
for me. Release it back down. Right arm's moving out to the side. We're just doing the second side here. Release out. Go back through center. Yeah, you got to do another dolphin plank one more time. Knees down. Draw up. Hands at your heart. This is a Lumbago hands, alright? So we're coming in out of cow pose with no hands. So that means it's your range of motion. Be smart. Be smart, my friends. We're gonna open up. And you'll bring it back to where you want. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Use that to pull yourself back up. Two more. Inhale. Exhale. Last one, inhale. And exhale, sink down, pause, breathe. How did that feel? Did you push yourself too far and now your back hurts? Like, you've got to take this information. and do something. Noticing behaviors, noticing tendencies. If we don't get mad at ourselves, we're going to do the same thing over and over again because we aren't listening to ourselves, right? Not speak it to yourself, listen to your body. Did your body just give you that feedback? If it wasn't good, then are you going to do that the next time you do that? Modify what we do to fit where we are in any given day. Come down, dolphin. Take a little step in. Don't overthink any of this. Just trust. Inhale, right leg up. Maybe take a little bit. Bring it back down. Left leg up. Maybe take a little lift. Bring it back down. Just keep alternating. And if you find balance and you want to stay there, don't feel like you have to keep alternating. Maybe you just find the balance and you hold. Yeah. It's all about shifting your body, about finding your center, about physics, allowing your fingertips and your hands and your forearms to catch you and to push into the floor to give you more support. To use your center, to use those abdominals that you just used here in camel to hold yourself in place. So it's not just throwing yourself up and praying that you catch. There's actually steps that help you to find that balance. Yes. And then child's pose, bring it down. Rise up, right foot comes forward. Okay. You're gonna lean back like you're going to camel. Yep, this might be it. This might be it. Maybe this left hand comes to your left heel and then you open up. Just maybe. Maybe. Inhale, rise back up. Bring your hands around, walk your right foot across. Come into pigeon. Good. If you can, bring your hands into your heart. So you're upright. Yeah.
It's hard to tell.
Good. You can use your hands if you need to, but see if you can shift. You can sit off to the right hip, bring the left leg around. Bring the right shin forward. Come into pigeon on this side. Take a few breaths. Yes, yes. And then shift into the left. Bring the right leg around. Come back into pigeon. And then maybe come forward, maybe bend the back leg and find your foot. So you get to explore. You're here for about 10 breaths. Good. Really nice. And then downward facing dog. Left foot steps forward. Right knee down. Bring it up. Channel the energy of camel. So that strong center. This can be it. Maybe bring the hand down, find the heel, and then open it up. You can kind of like shift back. Beautiful. Yeah. So this is strong. It's not just bending, collapsing back. It's strong. Rise up. Come around. Single leg pigeon. You got about 5 breaths here. Use your legs. See if maybe you don't need your hands down. You can be here and be strong. Yeah, ha ha. I love it. Love it.
It is working no hard now, darling.
Good. I'm going to shift so you can kind of fall over into that left hip. With control, bring the right leg around. With control, take the left leg back. Take a few breaths. And then come back around.
I'm always getting late now, baby.
And then we're here for about 10 breaths. So you can stay as is. You can come forward. You can take that back foot if you want.
Stick together,
one more time. Good. So this time, maybe we find a little more balance. So shift the heart forward. Look toward your thumbs. Walk your feet in. And your gaze doesn't have to go all the way to your thumbs. It can rest between your forearms. Take one leg up. And just maybe tip. And then switch. Keep the gaze steady. And tip. So really not putting a whole a lot of credit in holding it, right? You're gonna have flubs like me, I just fell out of it, no big deal. It's just part of the process. This is it. Spectacular, you are in child's pose yet again. Fantastic, fantastic. Really beautiful. And then press up onto your shins. Take your left hand to your right knee, your right hand behind, and just take a nice deep twist here. This is perfect. This is perfect. I swear on my life, this is perfect. If it feels good, you can push into this right hand, reach the left arm up and around, and press it. You did a lot of back bending, I know, and it has to feel good for you to want to do it. Come back around. And then let's twist the other way. Right hand to left knee, left hand behind. Open up. It's perfect already, but if you want, rise up. And then come back around. Take your legs. Bring the soles of your feet together. Baddha Konasana. Check in, how do you feel? Draw your knees in together. Roll down onto your backs. You're amazing. You're amazing. If you haven't told yourself that yet today, give yourself a hug and just say, I am amazing. And then whatever you need for Shavasana, you're going to set it up right now. So find where you want to be today. If you're comfortable in Supta Baddha, maybe bring the soles of the feet together, releasing the inner thighs, turning the palms to the sky, or maybe legs out straight. Big inhale. Open your mouth, let it go. start to soften your breath. Soften your body. Soften your gaze, whether your eyes are closed or not. State of being is for Bob. How do you feel physically? It's usually a very easy place for us to tap into. How do you feel emotionally? Mentally, spiritually, how do you feel in your whole being in this moment? Don't judge it, just observe it. And then slowly make your way up to sitting. When you're seated, bring your hands to your heart in prayer. And at the end of every practice, I always say namaste. And in case you don't know what it means that the light in me honors the light in you. This is a rough English translation. In that place of the light of me honoring the light of you, we are one. So in the place of me honoring you, we are one. So if you don't love yourself, you don't love me. If I don't love myself, I don't love you. We've got to love ourselves. Inhale, lift your heart to your thumbs, bow your mind to your heart. Namaste. Thank you.